Kol Halal, Yahweh, Baha Hashem Yahweh Shai, Baha Hashem Rakakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of great Millstone who taught me this truth and rule well. Salutation and salutations to the brothers out there that are laboring and pushing this truth and in sincerity and in charity and risking their lives and their freedom to do so. To you I say Shalom, to the Akiam and to the Akwath, that'll be you brothers and sisters. Adawan Rataza, that is to say Lord willing. Hopefully by the end of this lesson, you'll be edified. This is your brother Amawan Ibad from the GMS Miami camp. Back again with another lesson to the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai. To feed the lambs of Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, as commanded. And today's lesson is going to be entitled, Be Careful and Mindful What You Say. Okay? Be careful and mindful of what you say. And we all are guilty of things that we've said, you know. But at the end of the day, it's what you do, you know. Have you turned to the Most High and confessed your transgressions before Him, and repented and felt sorrowful and remorseful for things that you've done in your life, things that you've said, okay? Because the scriptures tell you that how you're going to have to give account for every idle word, man, and the time of judgment, you see? So once again, yeah, we all are guilty of, you know, things that we have said, you know, but, you know, the Lord say He will have mercy upon whom He will have mercy upon, right? And He will harden whom He will harden, roughly paraphrasing, you see? So it's all about your intent. It's all about your integrity, you see? Now, you could say something, you know, in your speech, and it'd be a slip of the tongue, meaning just in your speech, you might have accidentally said it, but it didn't really come from the heart, you know? So you can slip with your tongue, but it didn't really come from your heart. You didn't really mean that. It just came out a specific way. You probably said something, but you didn't meant to say it that way, you know? It's just, for an example, a lot of times we'd be doing a lesson, and you would actually be, this happened to me before, you would be reading a particular chapter, actually reading it, but you call that chapter by a different name. That's a slip of the tongue. You see? It slips. So, clearly it's just a slip of the tongue. You see? But, the scriptures tell you how it is better to slip on the pavement, right, than to slip with your tongue, meaning you say something, but you actually mean it from your heart. You see? So, right there, you're slipping up. Like you'd have a person, all right, let's say a person might have called somebody, say something really offensive to somebody. And then, you know, let's say a few days later, you might talk to the person who said it, and you ask him, you know, would they apologize to the person, or if they feel differently? And they'll tell you straight up, no, I feel the same way, I meant what I said. So he's coming straight from the heart. He didn't slip up. He said what he said, and he mean that. So at the end of the day, you're going to have to give that those idle words, you're going to have to give an account in that day, in the day of judgment, man. You see? But I don't want to ramble on anymore. Let me get into the scriptures. So I'm gonna start off with that scripture right there. As a matter of fact, bear with me real quick. Let me turn off the notification. Actually, I didn't do that, so I'm gonna have to do that real quick. Okay. Bear with me here. I'm turning it off real fast because I only got a few short time left to get into these precepts. Okay? So here we go. This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, all right? Chapter 20, and verse 18. And it reads, to slip upon a pavement is better than to slip with the tongue. So the fall of the wicked shall come speedily. So the scripture saying it's better if you slip down on the ground than to slip with the tongue. Okay? So you slip on the ground, you know, you might fall, you know, you're okay, it's not so bad, than to slip with the tongue. That could actually bring a real judgment upon you, man. You see? Ecclesiasticus, otherwise known as Sirach, the 20th chapter and the 18th verse, to slip upon a pavement is better than to slip with the tongue. So the fall of the wicked shall come speedily. You see? So that's what it's letting you know, man. You see, you're better off slipping on the pavement than to slip with your tongue, because scriptures speak about it. Those idle words, man, you're going to have to give an account for that in the day of judgment, man. You see? Now let's get, you want to stay in the book of Ecclesiasticus, otherwise known as Sirach, right? And we're going to go to the 5th chapter and the 13th verse, right? And it says, honor and shame is in the tongue. Okay, honor and shame is in talk, Salakia. Honor and shame is in talk, and the tongue of man is his fall. Okay, so honor and shame is in your talk. When you talk, when you speak, you know, honor and shame is in there, depending on what you're saying. You see? According to what you're saying, man. And it says, and the tongue of a man is his fall. So your tongue is very powerful. The scripture speaks about that. And this is why the title of the lesson is Be Careful and Mindful What You Say. You know? You could hurt somebody with your tongue. You could hurt their feelings. Not only that, you could cause them to bring wrath upon you, okay, because you hurt their feelings. All right? That's why the scripture says a soft answer turneth away wrath. The scripture speak about how there is power in the tongue. We're going to get those scriptures. You see? But let's go to the book of Matthew. Right? Let's get what our Lord said. Let's get what Yahweh Shai said. Okay, this is Matthew chapter 12. And verse 36, okay, it says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. Okay, so this is why you don't want to say anything out of your mouth, man. You see, this is why you gotta be careful. You see, you got to be careful with what you say. It says, verse 37, for by thy words thou shalt be judged, for by thy words thou shalt be justified, and for by thy words thou shalt be condemned. So it's going to be by way of what you say, man, what comes out of you. You see? Now, like I was saying in the beginning of the lesson, You could have a slip of the tongue, but you don't mean it from the heart, meaning your mind. It just came out that way. The scripture speaks about that. Okay, now we could get that. Okay, this is Ecclesiasticus chapter 19 and verse 16. It says, "There is one that slippeth in his speech, but not from his heart." Okay, meaning your mind. The Hebrew word for this word, your heart. Okay, the word there in Hebrew is lab, which means your mind. Okay, it says, there is one that slippeth in his speech, but not from his heart, meaning his mind. And who is he that hath not offended with his tongue? See, we all have said some things with our tongue. Okay, and this is the reason why you have to pray for the Lord to have mercy upon you. Okay, and ask the Lord to keep you in the way of righteousness, man, because we all have fallen short of the glory, and we all have said some things with our tongue. So we got to stay in prayer and be mindful you know, careful and mindful of what we say, you know, going forward. There was one that slipped in his speech, but not from his heart. And who is he that had not offended with his tongue? So we all, you know, in some way, you know, might have said something, you know, and this is why we have to seek the Lord to show his mercy toward us. You see? Right? So, at the end of the day, you might say, well, the Lord knows my heart. Well, the Lord does know your heart. You know? The Lord does know your heart, man. The Lord knows whether you're being deceiving or you're sincere when you say certain things or do certain things. Okay? So when you say the Lord knows your heart, yeah, because the Lord tried the reins of the heart. So he knows. He knows if you're standing on integrity or if you just being a foolish man or woman. This is Jeremiah 17 and verse 9. So if you say that the Lord knows your heart, he knows it. It says, Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 9, it says, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? You see? Verse 10, it says, I, the Lord, okay, search the heart and try the reins, even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doings. Okay? So, at the end of the day, the Lord knows, man. The Lord knows your intent. He know whether you're standing on integrity or you in folly. And that's why the scriptures say, the Lord will have mercy upon whom he will have mercy upon. Because he knows your heart. He tried the reins of the heart. You see? And that's why our Lord, that's why Yahweh said, it's not what goes into a man that defiles him, but that which comes out. Because that which comes out comes from your mind. You see, if you're eating food, that food goes into the body and it processes through the body and it comes out, secretes out through the bowels. But what you say, it comes from your heart. It comes from your mind. You see? Let's get that in the book of Mark. This is Mark. Mark, the 7th chapter, beginning at the 18th verse. It says, and he said unto them, this is red letter from this point on, our Lord Yahweh, are ye so without understanding also? Do you not perceive that whatsoever thing from without entereth into the man, it cannot defile him? Okay, so you only drink water, drinks, you know, food. It says, because it entereth not into his heart, meaning your mind, but into the belly, and goeth out into the drought, purging all meats. Verse 20, it says, and he said, that which cometh out of the man, that defileth the man, right? For from within, out of the heart of men, meaning your mind, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornication, murders. Did we not just read Jeremiah 17:9? Okay? The heart is desperately wicked. The heart is deceitful and desperately wicked. Who can know it? We just read that. You know, it says, verse 21, for from within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornications, murders, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lasciviousness, an evil eye, blasphemy, proud, and foolishness. All these evil things come from within and defile the man. You see? So when you speak it out, this is why you got to be careful and mindful what you say. You see? You got to be careful and mindful what you say, man, because it can have an immediate effect, okay, it could hurt somebody's feelings, you know. But you also can have an immediate judgment also, man. You see? So you have to be mindful and you have to be careful, or be careful and mindful what you say, man. This is Ecclesiasticus, otherwise known as Sirach. Okay, 11:33, call the Lord, I'm like, how about Shemel Shai? It says, Ecclesiasticus, otherwise known as Sirach, chapter 28, verse 18, it says, many have fallen by the edge of the sword, okay? Many have fallen by the edge of the sword, but not so many as have fallen by the tongue. So a lot of people have fallen by the tongue. Things that people said, man, accused people, you know, lied on people, falsely accused people, set people up, you know, say things they wasn't supposed to say at a certain time. The tongue, hey man, scriptures tell you, man, how there's power in the tongue, man. You see? And that's why you really got to be mindful and careful what you say, man. You see? This is Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 21. It says, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. So if you like to be going off at the mouth, okay, right? I think it's a scripture that says, he that keepeth his mouth, keepeth his life. Roughly paraphrasing. Proverbs 18 and 21. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. You see? Let me see if I can locate that scripture real quick. Let me see. Because I know there's a scripture that says that he that keepeth his mouth. It says, yeah, this is Proverbs chapter 13 and verse 3. He that keepeth his mouth, okay? What's in the mouth? The tongue, what you speak with. He that keepeth his mouth keepeth his life, you see? But he that openeth wide his lips shall have destruction. So, you see? This is why you got to be very, you know, very mindful of what, you know, very careful and mindful of what you say. And how you say it, you see? Remember, you're going to have to give an account, man, for every idle word. You see? Now, let's go to, we're going to go back to Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha. Okay, Ecclesiasticus chapter 28, and we're going to read verse 12. It says, if thou blow the spark. So if you see a situation going on, all right, before some people who love folly mix up on blem blem, as Benjamin would say, they see folly going on, right? They encourage it, but then a man of wisdom, a man of understanding, will do the right thing and try to cool it down. But let's read what the scriptures say. Ecclesiasticus, otherwise known as Sirach 28 and verse 12, it says, if thou blow the spark, it shall burn. So if you encourage foolishness, if you incite wickedness or bad behavior or frowardness, right? If thou blow the spark, it shall burn. It says, if thou spit upon it, if you try to cool down the situation, whatever is happening, if thou spit upon it, it shall be quenched, right? Here the last part of the verse, it says, and both these come out of thy mouth. So with your tongue, if you speaking out of your mouth, You could either use wisdom, or if you take the route of folly, it could cost you. You see, it could cost you. And that's why the scriptures say here, when you go to the book of Proverbs, okay, Proverbs, let's get it real quick. This is the book of Proverbs, the 15th chapter, and the first verse, it says, a soft answer, okay? A soft answer turneth away wrath. So you see a situation happening, a situation going on, you know, rather than answering softly, if you decide to blow more a fire on that fire, it could bring wrath, man, at the very same time. It says, a soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. So it's only where, you know, you decide to use wisdom, which will be the right thing to do, give a soft answer to cool down the situation. A soft answer turneth away wrath, man. But grievous words store up anger. So this is where your wisdom comes in now, to know to be careful and mindful of what you say. And that's why the scriptures say, let's get it. This is the book of Colossians. Let's bring this out. Colossians chapter 5 and Colossians chapter 4 and verse 5. It says, walk in wisdom toward them that are without. Walk in wisdom toward them that are without. You have to walk in wisdom, man. Especially to this forward generation, man. Generation of vipers out here, man. These GMO babies, you got to walk toward them in wisdom. It says, walk in wisdom toward them that are without, meaning without wisdom, those that are without understanding. You see, it says, walk in wisdom toward them that are without, redeeming the time. You know, you're supposed to be redeeming the time, right? So let's grab that scripture, and we're going to close out there, you know? So be careful and mindful what you say, you see? So let's, seeing that our Colossians end with redeeming the time, we're gonna get that in our, we're gonna get that in Ephesians, so we can close out with that. Especially that the time we're living in right now, man, we gotta be careful and mindful what we say. This is Ephesians chapter 5. I start from verse 15. It says, see then that ye walk circumspectly. Okay, looking around, checking you around about, not as fools, but as wise. Okay, not as fools, but as wise. Walk with wisdom toward them that are without. It says, redeeming the time, because the days are evil, man. We're living in bad times right now, and it's only going to get worse. So you have to be mindful of what you say. It says, wherefore be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine wherein in excess, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto the Most High and the Father in the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach. You see? So, yeah, man, that's it. I'm going to end it there. Lord willing, you were edified. Okay, be careful and mindful what you say. Until the next time, Shalom.